Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so we continue our lesson with chapter 4, in chapter 4 which is trigo. Okay, so trigonometric identities and equation. Okay, so AdMat dulu dah pernah belajar. So siapa yang tak ambil AdMat, so dia macam bermula daripada asal lah. Okay, so measurement of angle. Okay, so first kita tengok dulu measurement of angle. Okay, so if we measure the angle from here, so usually we measure from here. Okay, so daripada sini kita akan ukur daripada garisan yang ni. Okay, so if we measure clockwise, so the angle will be positive. Okay, for example here. Okay, so the angle here is, let's say positive 120 degree. Okay, contoh. Okay, so here actually here is 0 degree, here is 90 degree, and here is 180 degree, and here is 270 degree, and last one is 360 degree. Okay, so this one in degree. If in radian, this 90 degree is pi over 2, and this 180 is pi, and 270 is 3 pi over 2. Okay, so this one if you measure clockwise. If you measure anti-clockwise, so here, so let's say here, so this one is negative angle, so negative 150 degree, for example lah. Okay, contoh. Okay, so kalau ukur daripada clockwise, ikut arah jam, dia positif. Lawan arah jam, dia negatif. Kejap. Okay, so this one anti. Saya terbalik. Okay, so anti clockwise, dia positive angle. Clockwise, dia jadi negative angle. Okay, so clockwise. Okay, so saya terbalik. Okay, sorry. Okay, so tapi ni tak adalah penting sangat pun. Okay, so now next, sine of trigonometric function, symbol dia. Okay, so siapa yang dah pernah belajar, dia familiar lah dengan ni, add sugar to coffee. Okay, so for trigo. Okay, so this, what we call it. Okay, so this diagram will divide it into four quadrant. Okay, so this one is four quadrant one. Okay, so here is the quadrant one. Okay, so sukuan yang pertama, this one, quadrant one. And here is quadrant number two, sukuan kedua. And here is quadrant number three, sukuan ketiga. And this one is quadrant number four here, sukuan keempat. Okay, so if you take an angle in the quadrant one, okay, so sudut dalam quadrant yang pertama ni, sudut dia adalah antara 0 sampai 90 darjah, 0 until 90 degree. So 10 degree, 11 degree, 12 degree, 20 degree, 80 degree, 89 degree, 50 degree, okay. So tu semua tu angle antara 0 sampai 90. Okay, so if you take sine, cos and tan of that angle. Ambil sine, cos dan tan untuk angle-angle tersebut. So korang akan dapati bahawa the symbol of the answer here, okay, so symbol dia semua will be positive. Okay, so the symbol for all of this answer is always positive. For example, sine 35 is equal to positive 0.5736. He also same. Okay, so another example, this one, sine 50. Okay, so 50 still in the first quadrant. Okay, cos 50, tan 50. Okay, so all the symbol for sin 50, cos 50 and tan 50 is positive. Okay, so the answer is always positive. But in quadrant number 2, okay, so quadrant number 2, the angle between 90 degree and until 180 degree. So pilihlah apa sudut antara 90 sampai 180. Okay, so let's say here I choose 145. Okay, so sine 145, cos and tan. Okay, so the answer is negative except sine. Okay, so jawapan dia negative kecuali sine sahaja. Sine sahaja yang positif. That's why sugar S represent for sine. Okay, also same. So let's say another angle 130 degree. Okay, so sine 130 degree, the angle here, the answer here positive. The rest is negative. Same goes for the third quadrant. Okay, so untuk quadrant ketiga dan keempat pun macam tu juga. Konsep dia sama macam tu. Okay, so quadrant ketiga, value of tan is positive. And quadrant keempat, fourth quadrant, the value for cos is positive. The rest is negative. Okay. Okay, so and one more, if you notice here, the value always same. For example, sine 35 and sine 145. Value is 0.5736. Here is 0.5736. Nombor dia sama. Cuma yang berbeza dia untuk cos dengan tan ni, simbol dia sahaja. Sama juga dekat bawah ni. Sini pun. Quadrant 1, 2, 3 dan 4. Nombor-nombor jawapan dia semua sama. Cuma simbol dia berubah-ubah. So dia ada hubungan ni. Okay, so nanti dia kat sini dia ada hubungan 145 and 35. Okay, so kalau korang perasan, 145 plus 35 is equal to 180 degree. Okay. And then another one, 215 minus 35 is equal to 180 degree. And here 360 degree minus 35 is equal to 325. So kat sini dia ada relation. So nanti kita tengok lah apa relation dia. So tu lebih kepada reference angle. So nanti saya akan explain reference angle dan cara untuk mencari jawapan. Okay, so example ni, contoh dia yang ni lah. Okay, solve each of the following trigonometric equation for x between 0 until 360. Okay. Okay, so untuk menyelesaikan ni, biasa kita pindah-pindah lah. Okay, so first sine, we need to move this sine to the left. Tapi semasa kita pindah ke sebelah, okay, so tengok kat sini, ignore the symbol to find the reference angle. So first we need to find the reference angle. So let's say theta. Okay, so reference angle theta. Okay, so theta is equal to inverse sine square root 3 over 2. So which is equal to, okay, so which is equal to 60. Okay, so this is the reference angle. Okay, so what is the relation this reference angle in order to find the value of x? Okay, and what is the use of this symbol? Okay, so the symbol negative is this one, negative or positive. Okay, so the symbol we use to find at which quadrant the answer is located. Okay, so negative symbol kat depan ni, kita nak locate dia punya position sudut tu kat quadrant 1, 2, 3 ataupun 4. And then baru kita gunakan reference angle ni untuk cari x. Okay, so this one. Okay, so reference angle. Okay, so reference angle theta. After you get the reference angle theta, to find the answer in quadrant 1, which is x. Okay, so let's say x is the angle that lies on the quadrant 1. Okay, so to find the answer x which is lies on quadrant 1, so we use x equal to theta. For quadrant number 2, okay, so the position of the reference angle is here. Okay, so inside this triangle. Okay, so saya ada triangle OAB. Okay, so the reference angle inside the triangle. Okay, so to find the angle which is lies on the quadrant number 2. Okay, so to find the answer x, we use 180 minus theta. Okay, so 180 minus theta. So we have x. And then on quadrant number 3, yeah. Okay, so on quadrant number 3, okay, so to find the answer x which is lies on the quadrant number 3, so we use 180 plus theta. Okay, so ni x ni saya tersalah ni, dia sampai ke bawah. Okay, sampai ke bawah. So daripada sini pusing sampai ke bawah. Okay, okay, so therefore to find the answer x which is lies on the quadrant number 3, so we use 180 plus theta, because theta the reference angle is inside the triangle. Okay, and then for the fourth quadrant, okay, so untuk quadrant yang keempat, okay, so to find the answer x which is lies on the fourth quadrant, okay, so we use 360 minus by theta. So theta inside this triangle. Okay, so kita gunakan 360 tolak theta. Okay, so berbalik pada soalan yang tadi. Okay, so saya tulis kat sini. Okay, so jawapan dia, first quadrant x equal to theta. Second quadrant x is equal to 180 minus theta, because triangle here. Okay, so here is theta. And third quadrant x is equal to 180 plus theta. Okay, so because theta is here. And on the fourth quadrant, theta is here. So x we search by using 360 minus by theta. Okay, so now go back to this question. So we have sin x which is negative. Okay, so sin negative, symbol negative. See, which quadrant that give the sin is negative? Okay, so quadrant yang mana yang memberikan nilai sin ni negative? So we have quadrant number 3 and number 4. Okay, so number 4 ni sin negative. Number 3 also sin is negative. Okay, so add sugar to coffee. So add all is positive. Sugar sin, only sin positive. 2 is tangent, so tangent, only tangent is positive. And C, coffee is only cos is positive. Okay, so here for this example, sin negative is on third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Okay, so in third quadrant and fourth quadrant, so how to find x? So x is equal to 180 plus by the reference angle, which is 60, and on the fourth quadrant x is equal to 360 minus by 60. So we have the answer is 240 and 300 degree. Okay. Okay, so another example here. Okay, so find all the values of x which satisfies the following equation: 0, x between 0 until 360. So sin x is equal to negative 0.6018. Okay, so first find the reference angle. Let's say theta. So theta is equal to inverse sin 0.6018. So without the symbol. Okay, so which is equal to 37 degree. And then for the symbol, detect the quadrant. So sin negative is on the third quadrant and fourth quadrant. So therefore the answer of x is equal to 180 plus 37 degree and 360 minus 37 degree. So the answer is 217 and 363 323. Okay, so another question, cos x is equal to 0.5592. Okay, so saya dah tulis setiap slide tu. Okay. Okay, so first, find the reference angle, theta. So which is equal to inverse cos 0.5592. So which is equal to, okay, so which is equal to 56 degree. And then detect the quadrant. So cos here positive, so positive in the quadrant number 1. Add sugar. Okay, so add sugar to coffee. Okay, so quadrant number 1 and quadrant number 4. So therefore the answer of x is equal to quadrant number 1, just 56, and quadrant number 4, 360 minus 56. So which is equal to 56 degree and 304 degree. Okay. Okay, so next question. Okay, so next question. So this question. Okay, so if you have this question, for example, here we have cos and here we have cos. Okay, so seolah-olah macam sini darab, bila buat sebelah jadi bahagikan. And then you cancel this one. Okay, so step ni salah eh. Jangan buat macam ni, okay. So yang ni tak boleh. Siapa yang korang kena buat? Okay, so what you need to do is you need to factorize. Okay, so before factorize, so you need to bring this one to the left. So 2 sine x cos x minus cos x is equal to 0. Okay, so we have cos, and then factorize. So we have cos x 2 sine x minus 1 is equal to 0. And then cos x is equal to 0, and 2 sine x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so for this one, sine x is equal to 1 over 2. And for this one, inverse cos 0. So the answer is 180. Jap. Okay, so it's equal to 90. Okay, so if you from the quadrant. Okay, so cos 0 ni dia tak ada simbol positif ataupun negatif. Okay, so apa yang kita boleh buat? Kita just assume dia sebagai positif. Okay, so positif quadrant yang pertama dan keempat. Okay, so first quadrant and third and fourth quadrant. So x is equal to, for the first quadrant, just 90, and for the fourth quadrant is 360 minus 90. So we have 90 degree and 270 degree. Okay, so kalau korang nak assume negatif pun boleh. Jawapan dia akan sama 90 degree and 270. Okay, tak kisah pun. Okay, so for this one, okay, so we have inverse sine, the reference angle is equal to inverse sine 1 over 2. Okay, so inverse sine of 1 over, okay, so inverse sine 1 over 2 is equal to 30 degree. And then detect which quadrant. So sine, this one, so here, so the sine is positive 1 over 2. So positive is quadrant number 1 and quadrant number 2. Okay, so for the quadrant number 1, x is equal to 30 degree, and quadrant number 2 is 180 minus 30. So the answer is 30 degree and 150 degree. Okay, so next, another question. Okay, so yang ni mencabar sikit. Okay, so soalan dia boleh pusing kepada quadratic. So this one quadratic ni. So cos power of 2, and here cos power of 1. Okay, so kuasa 2, kuasa 1. Biasanya kuadratik lah. Kalau kuadratik dia ada kuasa 2, kuasa 1. Okay, okay, so for kuadratik, you need to factorize. So 2 cos square x minus cos x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, to factorize. Okay, so kalau siapa tak nampak, so you can assume this cos x equal to y. Okay, so you will have 2y square minus y minus 1 equal to 0. Then factorize. So you will have 2y, and y here 2y plus 1 minus 1 equal to 0. Negative 2 plus 1. Okay, turn. Okay, and then you take each of it. So 2y plus 1 equal to 0, and y minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so from here we have 2 cos x plus 1 equal to 0, and 2 cos x is equal to negative 1, and cos x is equal to negative 1 over 2. Okay, so yang lagi satu tu nanti dulu. Okay, okay, so from this one, okay, so we find the reference angle, inverse cos 1 over 2. Okay, so which is equal to 60 degree. And then since the answer here is negative, so it is located at, okay, so cos negative located at second quadrant and third quadrant. So the answer for x is equal to 180 minus 60 and 180 plus 60. So which is equal to 120 degree and 240 degree. Okay, so another one, for y equal minus 1 equal to 0. So we have cos x minus 1 equal to 0. So cos x is equal to positive 1. Then find the reference angle. Inverse cos 1. So the answer is, okay, so the answer is 0. Okay, so the answer is 0. Okay, so next detect the quadrant. Okay, so cos x is 1, so positive 1. So positive 1 is quadrant number 1 and quadrant number 4. So we have the answer x, which is equal to quadrant number 1, just 0. And quadrant number 4 is 360 degree minus by 0. So 360 degree. Okay. So dapatlah jawapan yang 4. Okay. Okay, so dah habis untuk yang tu. Okay, so next, 6 trigonometric ratio. Okay, so this one, sin x. Okay, so 3 basic trigonometric. So we have sin, cos, and tan. Okay, so for 6, for sin. Okay, so from the triangle. Okay, so daripada segi 3. Okay, so if the angle is here. So this one become opposite side. And this one is adjacent side. And this one is hypotenuse. Okay, so yang saya ingat ni sentiasa hypotenuse. Sini 90 darjah. Okay, so this one opposite tentang. So tentang dengan sudut ni. And here adjacent sebelah. Okay. And here note that theorem Pythagoras is important here. Okay, so sometimes they give length here and length here. So yang sini tak bagi. So kita kena cari yang sini guna theorem Pythagoras. So theorem Pythagoras mana? Hypotenuse power of 2 is equal to a power of 2 plus opposite power of 2. Okay, so go back to this sine, cos, and tan. Okay, so from this triangle, sine x is opposite divide by hypotenuse. Cos x is adjacent divide by hypotenuse. Tan x is opposite divide by adjacent. And also tan x, actually the definition is sine x divide by cos x. Okay, so nak hafal. Okay, so ikut cara masing-masing. So ini suggestion daripada saya. So this one is so. This one is cah. And this one is tua. Okay. Okay, so another three trigonometric. Okay, so dulu admit tak ada ni yang ni. Okay, so sekarang ada tambah lagi 3, which is cosec, secant, and cotangent. Okay, so cosec is 1 over sin x. Secant is 1 over cos x. Cotangent is 1 over tangent. How to remember? Okay, so how to remember? You need to remember the third word. Okay, so huruf yang ketiga. Okay, so for example this one, cosec. Okay, so huruf yang ketiga is sin. So sin is 1 over sin. Secant, huruf ketiga is c. So 1 over cos. Cotangent, huruf ketiga is t. So which is 1 over tan x. Okay, so here is the special angle. Okay, so this special angle actually is related to the first, which is we call it as equilateral triangle. Okay, so segitiga sama sisi. And second is about the segitiga sama kaki. Okay, so for the segitiga sama sisi, the length of each side is 2. 2, 2. Sini bawah ni pun 2. So 1 tambah 1. And then divide into 2. Dan lagi satu, properties of segitiga sama sisi, the angle of each here is 60. 60, 60, and here also 60. And since divide by 2, so here become 30 and here 30. And then the length of this side is square root of 3. Okay, so using the Pythagoras theorem, so korang akan dapat square root of 3. Okay, and then from segitiga sama kaki, okay, so here is 90. Okay, so 90. Okay, so sebab sama kaki, here 45 and here also 45. Okay, so sama kaki, we put the length here 1 and here 1. And here is square root 2 by using the Pythagoras theorem. Okay, and then by using so cah tua, so you will have sine 30, which is 1 over 2. Okay, so 30. So S O H 1 over 2. And then cos theta cah cos 30. Okay, so cos 30 cah C A adjacent square root 3 over 2. And then tan tua T O A, so 1 over square root 3. Okay, and then for 45, okay, so sine 45, so 45 here, SOH 1 over square root 2. Cos also same, cah CAH, okay, so 1 over square root 2. And then tangent 10, toa TOA, 1 over 1, which is 1. And same for sine 60, cos 60 and tan 60. Okay, sama juga, okay. So, korang boleh tengok nanti. Okay, so bila nak pakai socah tua benda ni? So, that thing you use. Okay, so that thing you use when you have this kind of question. For example, given that tan A equal to this one and cos B is equal to negative 5 over 13. Okay, so yang special angle tu, tak kisah pun korang nak ingat boleh, tak nak ingat pun tak apa. Okay, so where, okay, aku berbalik pada this example. Okay, so given that tan A this one, cos B this one, where A is an acute angle and B is an obtuse angle. So without using calculator, find the values of cosec square A and sin B. Okay, so biasa soalan macam ni, so korang kena lukis segitiga. Okay, so A is an acute angle. Okay, so lukis segitiga. So acute angle is here. Okay, so therefore the triangle is here. Okay, so angle here is A. Okay, so tan A is 1 over square root 2. So tan is opposite adjacent. Okay, so opposite is 1, adjacent is square root 2. So therefore here A, so opposite here 1, adjacent here is square root 2. And then using Pythagoras theorem, find the hypotenuse. Okay, so hypotenuse power of 2 is square root of 2 power of 2 plus 1 power of 2. Okay, so which is equal to 2 plus 1, 3. So this one h power of 2. So h is square root of 3. So here square root of 3. And then next, b. Okay, so b is obtuse angle. Okay, so obtuse angle is in second quadrant. Okay, so therefore we draw the triangle here. So this one is B. Okay. Okay, so for B, cos B. Okay, so cos B is equal to negative 5 over 13. Okay, so cos is adjacent over hypotenuse. Okay, so adjacent is 5 and hypotenuse is 13. So here 13 and here is 5. Okay, so kat mana negatif tu nak letak? Okay, so negatif tu letak kat 5 ni. Pun boleh, tak ada masalah. Okay, so letak dekat 5. Okay, so kalau tak nak letak 5 pun tak apalah. Okay, so biar je 5. Okay, so cuma nanti kalau cari jawapan ni kena make sure lah ada positif ataupun negatif. Okay, so just put 5. Okay. Okay, so and then since here 5, so find this opposite. Okay, so we have 13 power of 2 is equal to opposite power of 2 plus 5 power of 2. Okay, so 13 power of 2 is 169. Okay, so opposite power of 2 plus 25. So opposite power of 2 is 169 minus 25. Okay, so which is equal to 144. So opposite square root of 144 is 12. So here is 12. Okay, so since after you complete the triangle, so find the answer. Okay, so for the first one, A is cosec. Okay, so cosec square A. Okay, so cosec is 1 over sine. Okay, so since there is a square, so put square here. Okay, so it is equal to 1 over sine is SOH, opposite divided by hypotenuse, power of 2. Okay, so which is equal to 1 over opposite. Okay, so from angle A, so opposite is 1, hypotenuse is square root 3. Okay, so 1 over square root 3 square. And then it is equal to 1 over, so 1 square is 1, and then square root of 3 square is 3, so 1 over 3. So 1 over 1 over 3 is 3 over 1, which is equal to 3. And then B, which is sine B. Okay, so sine B. So B, S, O, H. Okay, opposite is 12, hypotenuse is 13. So the answer is 12 over 13. Okay. So next is trigonometric identities. Okay, so trigonometric identities. Okay, so this one about the negative angle. So sine of the negative angle. Okay, so negative angle tadilah yang pusing ikut jam. Okay, so sine of negative angle, it is also equal to negative sine positive angle. And cos negative angle, it is also equal to cos positive angle. So tan negative angle is equal to negative of tan positive angle. Okay, so maksudnya yang ada negative angle ni, negatif dia boleh keluarkan untuk sine dengan cos saja, kecuali sine dengan tan saja, kecuali cos. Okay. And then we have this identity, sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1, tan square theta plus 1 is equal to secant square theta, 1 plus cotangent square theta is equal to cosec square theta. Okay, so this identity used when there is quadratic in the equation. Okay. So quadratic equation involving the trigonometric equation. So kalau kita ada nampak yang kuasa 2 kuasa 2 tu, berkemungkinan kita pakai identiti ni. Okay. And then we have sum and difference of two angle. So sum ni maksudnya sine angle kat dalam ni kita ada tambah 2. Tambah ataupun tolak, A plus or minus B. So become this one. Okay, so sine A plus minus B, it is equal to sine A cos B plus minus cos A sin B. So kalau tambah, sini tambah. Kalau tolak, sini tolak. And then for the cos, cos A plus minus B, it is equal to cos A cos B negative plus sin A sin B. Okay, so kalau sini tambah, sini tolak. Kalau sini tolak, sini tambah. And same for this one. Okay, tangent. Okay, if here plus, but here minus. If here minus, but here plus. Okay. Okay, so this identities, so we use when there is sum or different in angle. So kalau ada pertambahan ataupun penolakan kat dalam sudut ni, okay? Dekat dalam sin dengan cos tan ni. Then double angle properties. Okay, so double angle properties, we have this properties, okay? So this actually double angle properties is from sum and difference of two angle. Okay, so if you use A plus by A. Okay, so this B substitute with A. So A plus by A, so you will have 2A. Okay, so dia tambah saja, tolak tak ada. Okay? So tolak tak yang buat. Okay, so orang boleh try nanti daripada sum and difference of two angle. So you will have double angle properties by replace B with A. Okay. Okay, so this double angle properties you will use when the trigonometric equation involving the double angle. So, nampak 2A, 2B macam tu, mungkin pakai double angle properties. Okay, so example this one. Okay. So, boleh nampak kat sini. So, this one double angle properties 2B. And this one A minus B. So, A minus B ni pakai yang sum and difference angle lah. So, before that, this one. Okay. So, we need draw the triangle. Okay, so this type of question, we need to draw the triangle. So tan A. Okay, so dia kata A is an acute angle. So acute angle in the first quadrant. So here A. So we have tan A. So tan is opposite, adjacent tua. Opposite is 1, adjacent is square root 2. And here, okay, so ni tadi sama, lebih kurang macam kat atas. So here is square root 3. And then B is of this angle. So here B. Given is cos B. So cos is cah, adjacent hypotenuse. So adjacent is 5. Hypotenuse is 13. Okay, so lebih kurang sama macam tadi. Yang diberin sama macam tadi. So here is 12. Okay, so without using calculator, find the values of cos 2B. Okay, so cos 2B. But here the angle given A and B, there is no 2B. So what you need to do? So So you need to use double angle properties. So tengok tadi cos 2b. Okay, so cos 2b here 2a. Okay, so maksud b ni sama dengan a lah. So korang gantilah a dengan b. Okay, so korang boleh pilih nak pakai yang mana. Minus 2 sin square a also sit, kan? Or 2 cos square a minus 1 also, kan? Just cuma jangan terbalik lah. Kat sini 2b. So maksudnya a ni tukar kepada b. Okay, so maksud kat sini cos 2b is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square b. Okay, so saya pilih yang 2 sin square. Okay, and then tan a minus b. So tan a minus b using this properties lah. Okay, so tan a minus b is equal to tan a minus tan b divided by 1 plus tan a tan b. Okay, okay, so lepas tu kita kira. Okay, so for the a, so cos 2b is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square b. Okay, so sin square b, sin b, so b here, sin is opposite hypotenuse, SOH. So opposite is 12 and hypotenuse is 13, then power of 2. So we have 1 minus 2 144 divided by 169. So which is equal to 169 over 169 minus by 288 over 169. So this one is equal to, okay, so it is equal to negative 119 over 169. And then b, so tan a minus b, so it is equal to tan a. So tan a t o a, so 1 over square root 2 minus tan b t o a, so 12 over 5 divided by 1 plus tan a. So tan a, so same, 1 over square root 2 times with tan b. So tan b is t o a, 12 over 5. Okay, and then simplify. So you will have, so yang atas ni sama ke pembawah. So 5 minus 12 square root 2 over 5 square root 2 divided by 1 plus 12 over 5 square root 2. Okay, so yang ni sama ke pembawah. Pembawah dia 5 square root 2. Okay, so you will have 5 minus 12 square root 2 over 5 square root 2. Okay, so divide. So 5 square root 2 plus 12 over 5 square root 2. Okay, so nanti tukar jadi darab. So saya punya tak muat, saya terus buat simplify lah. So tukar jadi darab, yang ni akan naik atas, yang ni akan jadi bawah. So korang akan dapat 5 minus 12 square root 2 over 5 square root 2 plus by 12. Okay, so siapa tak buat, tak boleh nak buat macam ni, tekan je lah calculator, dapat perpuluhan pun perpuluhan lah. Okay, okay, so next question. So next question is 5. Solve the equation 5 sin x cos x equal to cos x. For x is in between 0 degree and 360 degree. Okay, so this one, see here, cos x. Okay, so cos x here and cos x here. So therefore, this one you need to factorize. So in order to factorize, okay, so you need to put the right side equal to 0. Okay, so 5 sin cos x minus cos x is equal to 0. Okay, so yang ni tak adalah kaitan dengan yang soalan tadi. Yang soalan tadi tu segitiga, kan? Okay, so this type of equation, so it is related to triangle. Okay, so but this one, so this one is not related to triangle. Okay, so cos x, cos x. Okay, so factor out. Okay, so you will have here cos x 5 sine x minus 1, so which is equal to 0. So you take this one equal to 0. And another one which is 5 sine x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so first find the reference angle which is equal to inverse cos 0. Okay, so the answer is 90 degree. Okay, so tadi saya ada cakap 0 ni, so you can assume either positive or negative. Okay, so nak assume negatif pun boleh. So yang soalan atas tadi saya pernah assume dia positif kan. So ni kali ni saya assume dia sebagai negatif. Okay, so negatif, it is on the second quadrant and third quadrant. So the answer for x is equal to 180 minus 90 degree, and another one is 180 plus 90 degree. So the answer is 90 degree and 270 degree. Okay, so senang cerita, kalau cos x sama dengan kosong ni, jawapan dia betul-betul dekat sini ni lah. Palang yang ni dengan yang bawah. Okay, so yang atas ni 90 darjah, yang bawah ni 270 darjah. So kalau dapat soalan ni, nak terus tulis jawapan x sama dengan 90 darjah dan 270 darjah pun boleh. Okay, so second one, so you will have sine x is equal to 1 over 5. Then find the reference angle, inverse sine 1 over 5. So the answer is 11.554 degree. Okay, so this one is the reference angle, and then detect which quadrant. Okay, so sine, this one sine x is positive. Okay, so positive, so positive on the first quadrant and second quadrant. So the answer for x is, for the first quadrant is only 11.54, and on the second quadrant is 180 minus 11.54. So the answer is 11.54 and 168.46 degree. Okay, so next, another question. Okay, so solve the equation 2 sine square x plus cos x minus. Okay, so ada square. So berkemungkinan pakai identiti yang ada kuasa 2 tu. Ni. Okay, so tapi macam nak pakai? So kita tengok perlu pakai ke tidak. Okay, so first we look on the type of trigo. So the type of trigo here is sine, and another one is cos. So dia dua berbeza. Okay, so biasa kalau quadratic ni dua-dua mesti samalah. Kalau sine dia sine, kalau cos dia cos. Since here cos but here sine, so this sine square you need to transform using identity. Okay, so from identity you have sine square x plus cos square x which is equal to 1. Okay, so cari sine square. Okay, so sine square x is equal to 1 minus cos square x. Okay. Okay, so therefore from this equation, so you will have 2 sine square x which is 1 minus cos square x plus cos x minus 1 equal to 0. And then expand, so you will have 2 minus 2 cos square x plus cos x minus 1 equal to 0. And then 2 minus 1 is 1. So you will have 2 cos square x plus cos x plus 1 equal to 0. So tambah 1 sebab 2 tolak 1 adalah positif 1. And then factorize. Okay, so siapa yang tak nampak bolehlah let y is equal to cos x. So you will have negative 2y square plus y plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so to factorize. Okay, so the term with power of 2 must be positive. Okay, so pindah dia pergi ke sebelah ataupun multiply all of this one by negative. Ok, Okay, so you will have 2y square minus y minus 1 is equal to 0 times negative 0. And then factorize, so you will have 2y plus 1 and y minus 1 equal to 0. Okay. Okay, so from this one you will have 2y plus 1 equal to 0 and y is equal to negative 1 over 2. And another one, which is y minus 1 equal to 0, so y equal to 1. Okay. Okay, so selesaikan. Since y is equal to cos x, so you will have cos x is equal to negative 1 over 2. Okay, and then find the reference angle. So 1 over 2 without the symbol, okay? So tanpa symbol. So which is 60 degree. And then negative. Okay, so after that detect the quadrant. So cos x is equal to negative 1 over 2. So negative is on quadrant number at sugar number 2 and number 3. Okay. Okay, so we have the answer for x quadrant number 2, which is 180 minus 60, so equal to 120. Oh, one more I forgot, so which is 180 plus 60, so 120 and 240 degree. Okay. And for another one, so we have cos x is equal to 1. Okay, and then the reference angle is cos 1, so which is equal to 0. Okay. Okay, so 1 is positive, so positive quadrant number 1 and quadrant number 3. So the answer for x is equal to, for the first quadrant is 0 degree, and for the fourth quadrant is 360 degree minus 0. So the answer is 360. Okay, so another one. Another example. Okay, so this one, if you see this one. Okay, so it is related to triangle. Okay. So draw the triangle. Okay, so given sine A is equal to 6 over 10 is an obtuse angle. So obtuse angle is on second quadrant. So here. So the angle here is A. Okay, so sine is opposite hypotenuse. So opposite is 6, hypotenuse is 10. And then using the theorem of Pythagoras, so find the adjacent. Okay, so 10 square is equal to 6 square plus adjacent square. So we have 100 is equal to 6636 plus a square. So 100 minus 36 is equal to a square. So adjacent square is equal to 64. So you have a is equal to 8. And then second one, we have tan b equal to 12 over 9 acute angle. So acute angle is on first quadrant. So the angle b is here. Okay, so tan is toa, T-O-A. So opposite is 12, adjacent is 9. Okay, so find the hypotenuse. So hypotenuse square is equal to 12 square plus 9 square. So which is equal to 225. So hypotenuse is equal to 15. Okay, so dapat 15. Okay, and then find cos A plus B. Okay, so cos A plus B. Okay, so you use the identity of summation and different. So this one, sum and different of two angle. So cos A plus B, which is cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. Okay, so therefore for the first one, A, so you will have cos A plus B, which is equal to cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. So cos A, so using from the angle A, so cos A is charge adjacent hypotenuse, so 8/10. And then cos B, okay, so from the angle B, charge adjacent hypotenuse, so 9/15. Okay, so before that, I forgot. So cos A, A on the second quadrant. So second quadrant, the value for cos is negative. Okay, so negative 8/10. And then cos B, so cos B first quadrant, so positive lah. And then minus sin A, SOH, 6/10. Okay, so sin A on the second quadrant, second quadrant is positive. And then sin B, SOH, first quadrant is positive. So positive 12/15. And then calculate. Okay, so which is equal to negative 6/5. And then B. Okay, so cos 2B minus secant A. Okay, so cos 2B. So this one 2B using double angle properties. Okay, so double angle properties. Okay, so you can choose anything, anyone. So the, untuk cos kita ada 3. Ini double angle properties. Okay, so this one cos. So we have 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so you can choose anyone. So I use 1 minus 2 sin square A. Okay, so 1 minus 2 sin square, okay, so B here, so here B, and then minus secant, so secant is 1/cos A, so which is equal to 1 minus 2 sin B. Okay, so from the angle B, so sin B SOH, so 12/15, and it is positive because sin on the first quadrant is positive. Then minus 1/cos A. So cos A, C, A, H. So 8/10. And on the second quadrant, cos is negative. So put negative here. Okay, so the answer is, okay, so which is equal to 97/100. Okay, so next question. So solve the trigonometric equation cos x minus sin x tan x plus equal to 0. Okay, so for this one we have three go, cos, sin and tan. Okay, so what one we can use here, so to use identity, so this one cannot because there is no square. Okay, and then to use double angle, so there is no double angle here because the angle already x. Okay, so but you know that tan is sine over cos. Okay, so therefore you will have here cos x. Okay, so cos x minus sine x, tan x is sine x over cos x plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so sin x times by sin x become sin square x. Then, okay, so and then you need to cancel this denominator. How to cancel denominator? So to cancel denominator, so we can multiply with cos x. Okay, so cos x times cos x become cos square x. And then minus sin square x divided by cos x times cos x become sin square x. And then plus 1 times cos x become cos x is equal to 0. Okay, so now we have cos square sin square. Okay, so now we can use identity, which is sin square x plus cos square x equal to 1. Okay, so this one, okay, so I will choose sin square change into cos square. Okay. Sebab apa? Sebab kena ada cos. Okay. So cos x. And here cos square x. Okay. So better I transform this sin square x into cos. Okay. So how to transform? So from this identity, I have sin square x equal to 1 minus cos square x. Okay. So here we have cos square x minus sin square is 1 minus cos square x plus cos x equal to 0. Okay, and then expand this negative. Okay, so you will have cos square x minus 1 plus cos square x plus cos x equal to 0. Okay, so this one become quadratic lah. Okay, so cos square plus cos square to cos square x, and then plus cos x minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, after that, factorize. Okay, so you can let y equal to cos x. So you will have 2y square plus y minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, so factorize 2y minus 1 and y plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so from here you will have 2y minus 1 equal to 0 or y plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so from this one, solve. So you will have 2y equal to 1. So y is equal to 1 over 2. Or cos x is equal to 1 over 2. For another one, you will have cos y equal to negative 1. So cos x is equal to negative 1. Okay, and then solve. Selesaikan. Okay, so selesaikan for the first one. Okay, so cos x equal to 1 over 2. So first, find the reference angle. So inverse cos 1 over 2. Okay, so which is equal to 60. Okay, so next, cos x equal to 1 over 2. So which is positive 1 over 2. So this one positive is in quadrant number 1 and quadrant number 4. So therefore, we have the answer for x, which is equal to 60 and 360 minus by 60. So which is 60 degree and 300 degree. Okay, so for another one, so find the reference angle. Okay, so theta is equal to inverse cos 1. Okay, so without the symbol. Okay, so which is equal to 0. Okay. And then cos x is negative 1. Okay, so cos x negative 1. Okay, so negative is quadrant number 2 and quadrant number 3. Okay. Okay, so therefore the answer for x is equal to, okay, so quadrant number 2, which is 180 minus by 0, and quadrant number 3 is 180 plus by 0. So the answer is 180 and 180. So just write down 180. Okay. Okay, so I think that is the last example, last question. Okay, so that's all for our lesson today. See you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.